If you want that real, then watching your face. Gonna give it to you straight, raw, uncut. Can't deal with the fake. Sometimes we know we gon' ruffle some feathers, but we mean what we say. It's a lot of people who gon' do what we do, but we lead the way. If you want that real, then watching your face. Gonna give it to you straight, raw, uncut. Can't deal with the fake. Sometimes we know we gon' ruffle some feathers, but we mean what we say. It's a lot of people who gon' do what we do, but we lead the way in your face.
You getting standing over?
We definitely, yeah, man. We should take this conversation.
Should motherfucking chill. You know what time it is. You know what we came to do. The greatest show on earth. The greatest show in the Midwest. I don't give a shit what y'all talking about. If you ain't here, you in the wrong fucking place. Welcome to In Your Face Podcast. Another great episode. Another great week. Continue to like. Continue to subscribe.
Almost forgot. Gotta clap.
Almost forgot. Your choking kind of distract me a little bit.
Nah, man, I don't know what it is. I drink or eat. It's just drink stuff. It gets sticky. And then I just clear my throat out a little bit. That's crazy.
But yeah, man. Hey, man, we was having a conversation before the podcast started. Talking to women in person versus talking to them online.
I feel like it's easier online because you got time to sit and think about what you want to reply. When you in their face, You gotta talk, nigga. Like, you ain't got no time to sit there and be like, hold on, let me think how I want to respond to you right now. Like, nah, it's a flowing conversation. And then if you ain't got nothing to say, that awkward silence in here, like, well, all right.
I'll let you know what you deal. I think it's easier to talk to somebody in person. I'd let you know what you're dealing with. You get to see the whole package. It ain't no nothing behind a face shot. Because that's how a lot of these women take pictures nowadays, from like this up. You don't really know. Like, she be pretty as I mean, you still can't knock motherfucker pretty, but bitch, don't hide the 200 that's underneath.
Hey, I mean, you just gotta know the tricks of the trade now. If you get to a chick, usually she should have more than one picture.
Some bitches' faces be skinny, man. Mm-hmm. They be skinny, but look,
I'm gonna tell you something that they cannot ever counter, bro. If they ain't got nothing but 8 face shots, you already know what that body looking like. Yeah, you already know. I'll toot your face in. You ain't got no body shot in there. Okay, she might not want to show her body.
But you got a point with that whole, like, talking to them on the internet. You got time to reply. But when you, like, I think it's you have more of an intimidating factor as a man.
Yeah,
like, if you tower over a woman and, like, you really close up to them. That energy, like, they like, oh shit, this nigga all up on me. You know what I mean? Like, you take up the breathing room.
Plus, you get to deal with a lot. Like, a lot of times, y'all gotta think of the circumstances, man. When you out, like, you get to get this bitch. She's drunk. She's easier to talk to. You know what I mean? Like, she's sober as a motherfucker. You try to holler at her in her inbox on the internet. Hell nah. But she drunk, all kinds of shit going on. Yeah, she just trying to get crazy. She out. I think it's way easier, man.
Okay, but I think that anxiety of being, I mean, the world has made people antisocial.
True.
Like, it's the way the internet work now, you are antisocial. Like, it is probably the most intimidating thing to walk up to somebody.
That's crazy.
Which should be easy.
Yeah.
But it's the opposite. Like, your fucking hands get to sweating and
that,
you
know, rejection, what I mean? Boys don't know how to take that rejection no more.
That is true.
I'm telling you that's the fear. Be like, am I gonna say something? She might try to embarrass me or shut me down. Hey, I'm telling you,
I can't say nothing because I don't know. But they really be trying to embarrass motherfuckers?
I don't know if they try to embarrass them, but niggas be in their head and psych yourself out before you even get up to her.
Yeah,
you would see her?
Because in my head,
I don't know. Niggas do got, like, I don't know, gauges, I'd call it, where you can look at a female and know if she's in your range.
Yeah, of course.
You just look and be like,
of course. No, I 1,000,000%. You look confused, bro.
No, I don't give a fuck with any hoe.
But I'm saying,
I really got confused.
Bro, it's niggas out here, bro. You be like,
gotta be real.
Bro, you musty, them shoes ain't it. Bro, you know damn well. See, and this bitch and just pulled up in a Mercedes.
Yeah,
bro, you not that nigga for her, bro.
Like, you know, you woke up like, oh, this is gonna be tough. I ain't saying it's impossible.
Nah.
But nigga, they didn't have to save her life for, you, for her to give you a chance.
You ain't find it. That's why it's easier in person, bro. This is what makes it so much easier
but
in person.
But I don't think it's easier in person. I really do think it's easier online. Because, listen.
Y'all just said so much and confused me. I ain't gonna lie. My head just got going.
Bro. I'm just listening. I'm like, what?
Go ahead. The same thing, like you said, the internet made us antisocial. I feel like on the flip side, it made us more social because you can really talk to multiple chicks online.
Yeah, true.
You one at a time. I mean, you just going, bro. Just get the swiping.
Yeah, but that.
And then they just coming back.
Nah, it's no, it's no,
whole right, different see, conversations.
The thing of the element that everybody takes out, like you, that's cool. That's like McDonald's, right? It's fast food. But when you talking to somebody in person, that's soul food. Like you, I mean, it's different. Now you feeling energy. Yeah. Now you feeling you feeling vibes. You looking at facial expressions. It's way more intricate when you talking to somebody in person versus on the thing. You man, you could be like laugh out loud.
You can be
nigga face ain't straight as hell. Like you know what I mean? It's no personality.
You trying to send through what you would do in person through the text.
Literally.
So if I was in your face. And you said a joke, I'd be like, laugh out loud. Because if you was with me, I would laugh.
Nah, that
would be funny. But since you ain't here.
In actuality, like, y'all not funny. we just be doing it. Like,
some chicks be funny.
Nah, some people.
Some people, I'm about to say, I do know one. She be at me rolling.
Y'all don't be that funny in reality. Y'all just on some real shit.
My cousin funny. Hey, look, this is funny too. Look, because you know. Boy, recently, you know, single out here. So I've been asking y'all a lot about just dating advice. Y'all been telling me some stuff.
Right.
So I'm like, all right, this dating coach number one, dating coach number two. So I hit my cousin, it's a female. Yeah. I said, she gonna be dating coach number three.
Right.
And I asked her something that was so funny. I said, hey, G, go ahead and tell me why. Bless you.
Thanks.
Why I'm talking to some females and they hit me with something like, if you want to date more chicks, go ahead, don't let me hold you up. And I'm over here like, that don't make sense. Like, I'm like, gee, why they say that? She's just like, well, I don't know. They might be talking to more dudes, but at the same time, cuz you being too honest out here.
Yeah.
She was like, don't nobody be honest no more. We be lying. She said, everybody lying now.
Honesty is out the window.
I was dead. She said, I'm gonna tell you the truth, cuz you just gotta lie. Just that's what females want.
Yeah,
and
know.
Treat them bad. Yeah. I said, what?
Leave a comment in if that's what y'all like. I'm pretty sure she's right.
Hey, Jesus, she kept it real. She came from her own point of view. She was like, she said she let go some dudes that were good guys.
Because they were good guys.
And regret it now, but went for somebody else. And she was like, cuz I'm telling you now, you're a good guy. She was like, you gonna scare chicks off because you too good. You need to be bad. I was like,
Not necessarily bad, but just had that element of spice.
It depends.
In
it.
You gotta have a little bit of that Tabasco pepper.
It depends on what you're trying to attract. Because like she just said, she regretted. So it's some women that already done been through that phase. They don't want that nigga no more. They don't want the lying ass nigga. They want the nigga that you're trying to be. So it depends on what you're trying to attract. If you're trying to attract a woman that's early on, you just trying to get your spins in, then a lot of this bitch, I'm not telling you nothing the truth, but if you really trying to be with something, keep it above where you don't want
to
really
man, keep bro, it starting build to sound build more and more like, I just need to be myself.
Yeah, be yourself.
I told you, bro, at this point, at this element, bro, you literally just weeding out what you are going to take from here on out. Like, you literally weeding them out, bro. That's where you at right now. You don't even realize it.
It's in and out with them. Fuck them.
Hey, man. So, woo. If y'all new to the channel, man, this is your man. Iggy Flawless. Yeah. Next to my left.
Next to my
left. Hey, man, fuck y'all if y'all ain't fucking with me. Y'all know what time it is.
And it's Big Kev.
Boy, yeah, I don't know why we're introducing ourselves. At
we
this
just
point,
got
we
it
just
too.
Been talking.
Hey,
look, man. Y'all niggas is here, man. We know y'all fuck with us, man. Y'all know what time it is. We ain't got no hoes here. You know what I mean?
I wonder why.
Nah, let's keep this a buck. Let's get this shit out. They not coming back. And it is what it is. They're cool.
They actually still cool people. I don't have no problems with them, but they will not be coming back to the show at all. So we're looking for castmates, women, beautiful ones that have a good sense of.
You hit with an.
Let's clear this up. A castmate. I don't want two no more. That's too much. It doesn't work. No, just one woman. Cause old girl that came last week, that shit, she was good. Like, you know what I mean? She was cool. And it just showed that all we need is one female. It really just showed.
It depends on like I mean, like I said, I mean the type of I mean that
it has to be a good
one. It depends. See, that's tough because if it's one chick and it's three of us. Bro, when it comes to a conversation where we men and we all agree on a man point of view, she's going to get jumped.
Not really.
Like, she ain't even going to be able to debate back at all.
I mean, but a woman that knows how to handle that is argumentative, that is great with debate. Like, I mean, I know.
No, argumentative?
No,
I'm not saying it's good with debate.
They know how to articulate themselves and crush a point and make you rethink your point as she's talking.
Was over here like, ooh.
Yeah, I like that.
What Kevin's gonna say to that?
Actually, don't say what Kevin. What Kevin's gonna say
to that? Because you know I'm a go, goddamn it.
Yeah. But I do like that. Like, last week, that little back and forth with her, it was cool.
She a go.
It felt good, bro. I was like, her, bro. She think. She ain't saying nothing dumb. Like, I liked it. I was like, yeah, that was cool. We need a woman like that.
You know, hey, listen.
That's going to be tough to find.
To be consistent. Like, I can find.
I'm about to say, too.
I mean, I know a lot of smart women like that, but it's hard for them to be consistent because they got a lot going on.
We need to look for a woman that's older. Like, most of it is, like, of age. Like, it can't go from nobody. Well, I can't say that because, let me shut up. We need a woman that's really on her shit, like smart about it. Because we about to rebrand again.
So we going for We going for do we even care about looks anymore?
I don't think that should play too much of a role. I really didn't care about it from the jump.
Because some of the viewers did like how chicks look. I mean, that's good for
that's
views.
That's cool, but I don't want to. This ain't a show off podcast. It's literally we want you to understand what we're saying on this show. So it will.
I don't know. That's kind of tough because if we was just on some audio stuff, then it wouldn't matter how she looked. But since niggas can see us,
that's cool. But image matters. She not about to be butt ugly. We're not about to find somebody that's just goddamn. She's trash. We just gonna find somebody who's, you know what I mean? They all right, they cool. Something to look at. They ain't gonna be Jesus Christ, this girl's hit. She don't need to be in the camera. Like, she's something to look at, but you know,
some looks matter like to a saying. Point.
They always do. They always do. That's 100%. Yeah, they always do. Yeah, you're gonna be in camera. And I'm pretty sure she would know that. You're gonna be on camera, you're gonna wanna look your best. So.
Yeah, that's true too. I mean,
nobody wanna be embarrassed or call ugly in the chat.
Hey man, look, I gotta get this out. Some great things happened this week, especially in the world of hip hop. Great, great things happened. That Lox Dipset versus.
I ain't watched that one.
Oh my gosh, man. They put gumbo in the pot again. You know what I mean? It's been a long time. We've been eating Taco Bell. We've been eating fucking, you know what I mean? McDonald's, Burger King, all that shit. It was gumbo again. It was gumbo. It was Thanksgiving. For hip-hop, like, this was a great, great fucking versus, man. Hey, listen, my nigga Jadakiss put on a stellar performance. When I tell you, nigga was getting chills. I come from that. Like, that's my shit. Like, that's my element. When nigga's up there, he controlling the crowd. They talking crazy to each other. My nigga, I'm bars. Like, he made it feel like rap again. Like, that element of rap, that's the, this is no knock to the new school. That's the element that the new school I feel is missing. They can rap. That's not, I'm not saying that the new school can't rap. It's missing that oomph, that feeling of, damn, that's what our community is. That's what, you know what I mean? Like that sensation, like that versus was so classic. I definitely will put that right behind the Jeezy and Gucci.
It was good.
Oh, you ain't putting the Soulja Boy and Bow Wow up there?
Fuck no, that shit.
That was third.
That was good.
That was third. That was in the hip hop spectrum. Let me put that in perspective because Versus has been great and there's been a lot of classic verses. Yeah. For the hip hop spectrum, I would put Jeezy, Lox versus Dipset, and then Bow Wow. Those were the ones that was that one with Rick Ross and 2 Chainz. That was a wash.
Yeah, that was true. I was switching Locks and Jeezy and Gucci.
You think that was better?
Yeah, I think that one was crazy. That nigga Jadakiss really went crazy.
It's crazy because I didn't even hear about that one coming up. I felt like for a second Verses fell off because I felt like I done missed like two of them.
Doing like a big one. Now they're huge now, bro. Like I'm talking about big.
I don't know why I didn't hear about it at all. I didn't even know it happened.
It was nice, bro. I got goosebumps watching that shit, bro.
Jadakiss. Man, he be spitting, bro. I'm like, oh my god, that shit was giving me goosebumps, bro.
Back and watch. Yeah, bro, you enjoy. I don't know if you would enjoy it, cause that's more the.
Yeah, that's what we grew up on. Come on, man.
I don't think you wouldn't like it. Bro. Yeah, I don't think he wouldn't like it. I think he would like that one. I think you would like that one.
That's what I grew up on. I think you would like more the bickering. Yeah, it's dope, bro.
It was more the verses.
Like they was talking super
shit.
Crazy.
They was talking straight shit. My nigga was yanking boy's shoes up on him. Mother, I like.
Yeah, my nigga kicked him, bro.
Yeah,
like, what the hell is going on out here?
And they about to go on tour, bro. That shit about to be nice.
Yeah, hey, a lot of them keep saying that. Yeah, boys, they make some money off that.
Yeah, Versus is doing. Versus is actually doing a lot. Like, I wanted to kind of tie that in and to progress the conversation. I definitely wanted to shed light on that Versus. That Versus was cold.
Yeah, it was tight.
That motherfucker was. Hey, listen, that was everything that I needed. That made me feel what I needed. I know it's gonna go back to the normal, but that's tying into what I wanted to get into. I feel like, and this, Kevin, I know you more into clothes and shit than anything. Do you feel like Yeezy could take over for like Nike?
Yeah.
Do you think he could be a bigger brand than Nike?
No.
You don't think so?
Fuck no.
But then, I'm just, now, hear me out before, because you answer it kind of fast. I want you to hear me out. Just think about it in the whole totality. This nigga... We don't know where to get his merchandise at. Mm-hmm. It's always sold out.
Yeah.
And it is at the high, the premium of premium prices.
Yeah, it is.
Like, that shit is expensive, nigga. Slides, $300. What we got on? $300 for his slides.
Yeah.
You can't get them nowhere.
Yeah.
That's what, and I just want to put that in perspective. Like, I think the
hit. I got a pair of them bitches, and I regret it. I just bought a pair of them bitches last week. Regret it. Made a post about it. Like, why the fuck did I just buy these goddamn slides? But they nice. I guess they feel good.
But yeah.
Nah, bro. I shouldn't have bought that shit. Like, damn. They went three though. They was like 240.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that is like 240, but shit, that's still high.
Yeah, man. Like, I'm in my mind, like, that ain't much matter. Like,
but I mean, just that the thought. I just want to put it in perspective. I think the hip hop community. Don't get his just due.
It don't.
Like, just how much we, like, impact everything, mm-hmm. clothes. Ross and Diddy, they doing crazy with the alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
And Wingstop, just speaking to all the things. I ain't gonna look. I can't even get. I'm getting excited.
Right.
Jay-Z got the whole athlete thing.
Yeah,
like
he got a lot. That nigga got a lot going on.
Rappers or... Rihanna just became a billionaire.
Yeah.
So
I'm speaking to that. But you see what I'm trying to speak to? Like, just where it's going to, like, niggas is evolving. Like, we got damn near like 4 or 5 billionaires in the past, what, year or two?
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just from rap, and niggas was rappers and singers, bro.
I just had to get that money.
Yeah.
Start investing in the right things.
I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you. The only reason. So listen, I think Ye.
Just get back to the point.
Yeah, I think Ye can be bigger than a lot of brands. Like I could say, like.
What brand do you think he'll be over? Before, when it's all said and done, when he just now because I feel like he's solidified now. But I think he need to get to that point where it's just mass production. I don't know if he aiming for that.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
I think that adds value to it because you can't get it.
Yeah.
That adds to it.
That's why I don't think that's a good point. Because that's why I think he look at it like how Jordan do. Jordan do the same thing now. It's like, nigga, yeah, y'all can get them, but y'all motherfuckers gonna have to really work, sit on y'all computer for hours, clicking, refresh, to try to get them.
That make it.
And make it popular. But the nigga who benefiting off that shit is Adidas. Like, at the end of the day, Adidas own Yeezy. So, they benefiting like a motherfucker. That's why I don't think he'll be bigger than Nike. Because Nike is, when you talk about, like, brands, Nike is damn near the powerhouse of all brands. You talk about...
No, I'm talking about him separating himself from, like, just becoming his own entity.
Oh no, still not Nike. Nike is an entity. Like them niggas are.
Yeah.
Them niggas are the. That you can throw that fucking swoosh on anything and just charge absurd amount of money and people gonna really fuck with it. Like I be seeing white people with no lie, cause y'all the ones who really buy the shit we don't think of really getting until y'all get it. And then we be like, I didn't even know they do that shit. Like white people get some shit from Nike that like even if I go to the gym that I've never seen before. I'm like, Nike make shit like that? Mm-hmm. Then they start getting into the hijabs and shit like that. Nike be on it. Nah, Ye gonna be big as fuck. Like he's big as fuck now. Like and I don't see it slowing down. But it's
and
just,
that's what I'm saying.
That's
a titan.
Yeah, bro, they different, nigga. Nike got a bag. Like,
but I mean,
they got too many.
This is always this is always my argument. What if, right?
Yeah.
Because I mean, just think about his trajectory.
Look at how
short of a span his shoe and his brand been going. Well, and where he in the magnitude that it reached.
I'm gonna tell you
a 10-year span.
I'm gonna tell you why his shoes went so crazy. Alright, so first off with Nike. Them
Yeezys
he had with Nike.
Yeah, them motherfuckers was cold.
They was hard, but they was expensive as fuck. Niggas love expensive. It doesn't matter, white, black, any, they love expensive.
I got something you don't.
So he was already established with Nike. Shit didn't go the way he wanted. He kind of fell off. And then Adidas like, fuck it, we'll pick you up. Then he comes out with the Boost. They first drop, everybody and they mama was like, bro, what the fuck are those? Then you start seeing people grabbing them. People start buying them over and over. And then it became to a point where, oh, you can't get these. Like, you cannot get them. That's all it takes with a brand.
I've never seen them in this
store. Yeah, there's no way. Because you can resell them for like, if you buy a shoe for $220 and you can resell it, and double your profit. That's what most motherfuckers do nowadays. They just resell shoe. The shoe game is fucking ridiculous.
I'm definitely into that. That's the next business venture.
What, that shoe game shit? Yeah, that shit's ridiculous.
You done with the real estate?
I'm trying to tie it all together. I'm working. It's like it's harder. It's harder to do it all at once. But
it is. That's what I'll about to tell you. Just pick a path and kill that.
Yeah, that's. I mean the truck doing everything for me. So I mean but that's the next thing. But I mean even that, just getting back to the conversation, I just feel like we too intricate. I mean, integral to everything. Like our community, we are the most impactful when it comes to everything.
Yeah, true.
I don't know why we don't use it. Cause even Travis Scott, real quick, before you say your point, I went online.
Oh yeah.
I seen it. Bro, it's selling for $2,000, $3,000. Yeah. One of them, these ones, I posted on Facebook.
What, the SBs?
Them motherfuckers was $100,000.
Oh, and that's the one somebody bid it for like $23,000.
No, they didn't bid. That's how much they cost. Like that is a price.
Yeah,
that's
when I seen
the
SBs.
Bro.
The SBs.
So what I'm saying, and somebody's gonna buy them shoes. So I promise you, somebody is buying them shoes.
Yeah.
And they just gonna put them up.
If you got a pair of Travis Scott 6s, you can sell them for $6,000.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, if you really want to get into the shoe game, my cousin Thomas, that's what he does. This motherfucker, like that wall you got right there is full of shit that nigga shoes. I think he has a problem. And I tell him all the time, and this not trying to be funny, I'll be like, well, I think you have a legit problem. He doesn't buy his shoes for the price that we'll get them for, like regular store price. No, he'll pay that extra $200-$300 for a fucking pair of shoes and don't wear them. Like they just sit there. And I'm like, you got more shoes than clothes, bro. What are you gonna do with all this shit? Like, I mean, to me, that's when you just getting out of hand. Cause are you reselling them? And it's like, nah, I want them for me.
Yeah.
Like, nah.
Boys don't do that.
I don't know. I like clothes more. Yeah. I like clothes way more. Like way more.
And I think that's kind of like what I want to stay on the point. Like, who is going to come out with the fashion? I can't fuck with Ye clothing. I'm gonna keep it real.
I like his shoes
is cold.
I like it, but
it's I like his shoes.
It ain't for me.
I ain't gonna say it's cold, but I like some of his shoes.
Is his clothes the one that's looking all bummy?
Yeah.
I like it, but
I just couldn't put it on. I do like it though. If you can pull it off, man, good for you, bro. I wouldn't try. Like me, I wouldn't try. But I do like it. It's different. It's different as fuck.
But some of that shit, it do look a little extra. Like the shit he doing now with the mask and all that, that to me is like, yeah, I fuck with you different, but that shit extra as fuck. Like, it just to me is like,
man, I mean, it's kind of doubling down on the Pooh Shiesty shit.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, if you think about it, that was literally the trend, like, yeah, the whole mask, you know what I mean? So he just said, fuck it, I'm going to just get something to cover my whole fucking face.
I really got the fencing mask, though. He got the fencing mask. No lie, bro. Like, he has a whole fencing mask on and shit. I
just wanted to have that conversation.
The fencing, that do remind me of the Olympics.
Yeah.
Well, I have a whole problem with the Olympics right now. I've been watching the Olympics heavy this past couple weeks. I actually enjoy it, for real. These niggas let a transgender win the weightlifting competition in a women's division.
I seen it.
Are you serious?
I seen that shit.
Bro, when I seen that, I was hot.
Ain't nothing we can do.
What is they on? Like, that don't even make no sense. That's a man.
Ain't nothing we can do.
He just won the women's competition, and you should have seen the other two chicks behind him.
They were shitty.
They was looking at him like.
Samoan chicks. They were Samoan. They was hot.
I'm like.
Yeah, I mean.
What's.
Ain't nothing you can do.
I'm confused.
I mean, we're not looking for fair anymore. We're just looking for what we feel like they think was right.
It's equality, right?
Bro, that don't make sense. I mean, we're not looking for fair anymore.
I mean, we've been saying that. We kind of been saying this for the past couple weeks. We kind of been on the LBG RESPT.
I mean, and that's it, even. I don't know, bro. I mean, if you be honest with yourself, even other transgenders, y'all should know, if you was born a man, you shouldn't be in women's competition. Stop. Yeah,
true.
Stop. You want to be a woman, okay, be a woman. But don't go over there and start beating them up in their own stuff. Like, come on.
Yeah,
true.
Bro, I agree.
That made me hot. Also had, dang, what's her name? Athene Moe. She won 800, and she the first black woman to do it in 53 years. Dang, she did her thing. She did her thing for real. Like,
is that the girl that fell? Got back.
No, she didn't fall. No, she just ran an 800. I seen that chick too
that
fall and got up
and won.
Yeah.
That's crazy. She was way behind.
Yeah,
bro. I'm like, damn.
She pushed it.
And that's nuts, man. Yeah, that's the Olympics is crazy, man.
Yeah,
it really is. The Olympics is crazy, dude.
So I definitely.
And every country has they thing. Where it's just like, yo, you damn near know what country about to dominate in certain shit.
Boy,
it's just because you gotta think. Like Americans, all right, let's go with America and China. China practices shit that we just be like, bro, what? And we practice sports that's like, y'all physically, y'all not genetically capable of being as good as we are. Because we throw niggas in here. When you get to throwing niggas, you got blacks in USA with the other Africans. And you get what I'm saying? Like, and they paying these advanced science shit to get us all superhuman. Like, it's different, bro. Like,
it's funny, but when niggas go against some other real niggas, it be ugly because, boy, track them Jamaicans be killing us.
They smoked this year, but that girl didn't get the run. That was kind of fucked up, but they did still show up.
That's what I'm saying.
But still,
congrats
to Jamaica.
Boy, we would have seen her race.
Yeah.
Woo, I don't know if she would have won or not because, boy, they had two Jamaican chicks that was. One chick broke the world record again, the Olympic record or whatever.
She broke it, but
she pointed at it coming through
the finish line. Got it. A girl could have down there got it. And the reason being is because they all did their racing, you know, the little
trials and stuff. Yeah,
and she had the fastest time.
She had the fastest time in the United States. That's what I said.
No, her time was faster than both of theirs, too.
You know it was.
It was.
It just when the race came.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. She would have had time. She'd have had more time to train by then.
Dude would have
probably would have smoked.
Dude was calling it, bro. I love the announcers, bro. Dude was like, hey, if this nigga wanna win this race, he's gonna have to set a personal best. Like, that's letting you know. You gotta be better than you was
Olympics
last race,
great, man. That's such a tight race.
I love it, bro.
Really is such
that's,
a tight
yeah, race. That's the best of the best.
Yeah,
like
the superhumans, of the world. No lie,
hey, for real.
This is the Olympics, like the people who hurt, break bones, bleed, cry. This sport.
All
the best, nigga. That shit's crazy. Them motherfuckers is crazy, bro. The Olympics is nuts.
I am happy.
You really don't understand how talented them motherfuckers is until you try it.
And how much work they put in for it.
Until you try it. Get on a balance beam and start hitting tucks on that motherfucker. Yeah, all right. Been broke your fucking neck.
Which is Simone Biles, she said
she stopped.
She had a mental issue.
She
it was a trigger. Yeah, which, man, hey.
Yeah, they said, because, I mean, they said they was judging her unfairly.
Yeah, nigga, I'm so like great that y'all won't give me my just dues. That's right. Fucked
bro,
up.
Bro, they was putting mad pressure on her, bro. It did not matter what she did. Any little, bro, I can't even imagine being under that type of magnifying glass. Any mistake you make, it was like news.
They so like, oh, used to her being she stepped perfect.
Out. Oh, she, and that's what I'm saying, bro. That pressure, bro. I feel like it's
not gonna leave.
I heard a lot of it was. I'm not too familiar with it, but I heard a lot of it was she was doing moves that
nobody else could do.
Yeah, so they was judging her on a different pen.
Yeah. I mean,
so I said that is unfair. That's
I mean, I seen one of them when she did that tuck like three times in a row. Yeah, I was like, what
and,
the
yeah,
fuck?
Yeah, and twisting and junk. Like,
I was like, man, this
she
girl
just named her move crazy. After her because nobody else could do it. I mean, bro, she at a different level for real. I mean,
and that's crazy. And it's not just a different level like in some USA. This is worldly. Like, this bitch is. Nobody crazy else on the planet. Like, I'm legit planetary threat, nigga. I am a planetary threat to y'all. That's like, that's bad. Insane.
I'm glad she did pull out though. That's when she did that one little twirl and lost her where she was at in the air and just pulled out. That's good because it would have been bad if she would have kept pushing. So I'm glad she did get out and make it back in one piece, like she said. Curiosity. I really do want to know what she said was a trigger. Something made that happen.
She didn't really
put it on there.
Yeah, she probably talk because everybody gonna push her into knowing. You know what I mean? Wanting to know because mm-hmm. she's so popular. Like she's so popular. Because I remember it was a time where Gabby Douglas was like the it girl. Then she
yep,
came
because she was
it.
The first black woman to win. Yeah. Like yeah,
then
all
she
around
came
or something
and
like that.
Just destroyed everything anybody was doing. Like I'm gonna show y'all how I really get down. This shit just went crazy. Yeah. I'm like,
that's crazy,
God,
bro.
Damn,
she just
man.
Them genetics was perfect, bro. The height she had, the strength.
Let me ask y'all this. How y'all feel about them women so muscular like that?
That's cool to me.
I don't know, bro.
That's cool, bro. If anything, bro,
they are muscular, bro.
What you talking about, gymnasts?
Yeah, bro.
Nah, bro. That
I know
good,
it's
bro.
Tight. That's good.
They look good.
No, they
bro.
Be pretty in the face,
this
but
nigga want to wrestle with.
Yeah, bro. They be. Bro, I'm talking about. They
I'm not.
Veins
I don't want
popping
no
out.
Girl.
I'll be like,
Jesus. Man, listen to me. Listen, there's a difference
that
right now. Listen.
No, I get what you're about to say.
There's a difference.
The weightlifting muscular.
There it is.
Big muscular.
Big muscular.
Right,
I love it, bro.
I don't want a
weightlifter. I don't want.
I get that.
I don't want. She can't be that kind.
But muscle booty bothers me, bro.
Oh, no. That's nice.
What?
And tight.
Bro, what the fuck? Bro, no. That motherfucker has some jiggle to
this.
Yes. I want a little jiggle, bro.
Bro.
I'm not saying it gotta be, bro, no, just a little bro. Jiggle, bro. Your booty hard, I can't squeeze it.
Bro, it ain't
your
hard.
Ass can flex.
Hey, I'm gonna tell y'all something, man.
That nigga snapping.
I don't know what this is.
Bro, to me, it is very attractive.
No, it's not.
If a woman, get a booty,
damn.
That motherfucker don't move.
Damn! If a woman can keep up with me, bro, I love it, bro. She can get down.
I get what you mean. I'm like,
let's
the
go paintballing, all that. Like, she can do it. But I don't
nigga,
want no she, chick that's just so white.
Nigga, her physical capabilities probably better than this nigga. That nigga
sliding on the ground.
Right, she over here. That's
John Wick.
I'm with her. That's my girl.
Hey, yo. Since you said paintball, bro, we need to get that going.
Oh, we can.
Look, before it get cold, like, next week.
What brings
bro,
that up?
Bro, we ain't did that this summer, bro. We need to go paint.
I do leave that up to Tony, which I'm going to make sure I tag you.
I got a squad that'll come, bro. I can get boys that just come. Like, I'm saying, I can get that bitch fat.
Oh, cool.
Last time I went, bro, I was putting motherfuckers down.
Was it?
Yes, sir.
Did you go with me?
I don't know if you went with us. It was me. Remember my buddy Lonnie? Because I don't know if you went, but I got shot in the neck.
I don't know if I went, but I wouldn't have missed that.
Because I called everybody. Yeah, I told everybody. I got shot in the fucking neck, though. That shit hurt, bro. Paintball and raw skin. That shit.
How many niggas you think you can get, bro?
I can get about, no, with paintballing, bro, I can get about 10. Swear to God, Lonnie, I know he'll bring everybody out like he did last. Last time we went, it was like 30 of us. We damn near got put out because we was beating the team so bad.
Bro, I damn near think I think I can get 10 too, bro.
Yeah, we can do that.
It could be my squad versus yours.
I'm with it. I'm with it.
I think
bro.
That'll make it fun.
I'm with it.
Bro,
you fun as fuck. Paintball fun as fuck.
You with me, Milton? You asked
me
real quick.
Well, man,
real quick.
Take you from the
dog. Yeah, I'm with you.
No, I'm not.
Nigga sat back like. like,
I be trying to take my boy. Nah, bro, we, that sound like a good. Hey, and we don't put that. We can post that on our channel too. We need to do a Patreon, man.
What you mean? What is
like that? People pay. Yeah, they pay so it's they like can Twitch. See shit outside of the podcast. Like, see what
how goes do we on get with, that going?
Just like, sign up like Patreon. You literally
it's
sign,
an app.
It was a it's a site. So you just sign up, put our podcast through Patreon, and it can, you know,
see the off brand stuff.
They can see the shit be, that we doing outside of the
bro,
show. Like, if you
I
do,
mean, bro, if you want to walk, if you want to walk,
more
to, like, yeah, if you want to walk to, yeah. I mean, like,
yeah,
I don't know, bro. We could just talk about it and figure out how to do it. I mean, I'm with it. I mean,
let me ask y'all a question. I know yes, that we could do that too.
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, how y'all feel? Because I mean, that right now, I feel like we building way more than we are harvesting crops and farms and shit.
Yeah.
No, that's are y'all getting nervous yet? Or y'all just like, fuck it, we just live day to day?
Nah, I'm gonna say I got it in my head that I live day to day. I can't sit here and lie. Like, I'm not gonna sit here and act like I am
you
getting
worried
nervous
about the world in general.
Yeah, I'm always worried about the world, but it's not that hasn't really kind of ran through my mind. Like,
I mean, if you think about it, I mean, right now
it is true though.
I mean, at this point, nobody is really harvesting. Nobody's really farming anymore. Mm-hmm. Everybody is like pretty much just going to the grocery store and getting their food.
Well, I think the reason is because these big ass advances in science, these motherfuckers are making vegetables and making plants, making fake.
They're cloning.
They cloning shit. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, mm-hmm. It's to the point where they're trying to get rid of the they're trying to make more space. You see that what they doing with the rainforest and shit. They trying to really tear shit the fuck down so
bro,
they can.
If I could clone myself,
I wouldn't.
I would be a beast.
I honestly would never want to do that ever. I would never want
to. What? Yeah, well, I would love to have two nicks.
That nigga's crazy, bro. The world don't need two nicks, bro.
They don't. We don't.
That nigga, what, bro? No.
One is
hey, leave a comment if y'all think we need two nicks in this.
Bro, just imagine, bro. Two nicks got your back in the club.
No, bro.
Beating up anybody.
Just one nick, bro.
I'm beating up anybody.
Just one nick. All we need is one nick. You good?
Nah, bro.
No. Contact me if you do clone. If I can't make it, I'll send my clone to the podcast. Hey, handle that for me.
Bro, that would just give you a reason to be absolutely lazy. You're going to make your clone do everything.
No,
it's going to be getting worse.
We're a team.
That was actually a movie.
If I'm hitting a chick, I mean, I might nut quick or something. Bro, get my clone in there real quick.
So y'all about to just train everything moving.
Bro, she going to be like, you're the best. I'm like, I know. She ain't gonna know we switching in the dark. Just,
you are fucked up in the head.
You gotta think, bro. You got a clone. You can do something.
The purposes of your bone is fucked up.
Clone, this week, you go to work. I'm off. Next week, I go to work.
No, sir.
Bro, what?
That shows you the progression in our brain.
Feed, nigga.
No, listen, our brains and how it works. I just said something serious. If my niggas took us somewhere completely.
That nigga Nick be on some other shit.
Cause I feel you. I feel you, bro. But when you said clone, I'm like, I ain't just like a little cloud came up. Like, oh, I could clone myself.
That shit.
But I know it's some women out
there. I do
want to
start.
On some
real shit, I do want to start like growing my own shit and harvesting my own food.
Go to
that's
up.
What's up. You got a whole backyard to do it too.
Go on up. I about to say go on Sherman on the 34th and Sherman. They have a whole little garden over there and they teach people how to garden for free.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to get to.
Yep, they teach you.
Yeah, when I see you start getting it popping, that might be the motivation I need to get mine popping.
Yeah,
true.
I mean,
you
this,
got land now.
I mean, yeah, at this point, sure. I mean, nigga, and the nigga plan on. I mean, to be real, they making it where it's cheaper. And it's just a real quick speaking on the real estate shit. I know a lot of people like. A lot of people just getting started and they pulling, boy, they fucking a lot of people over right now.
Boy.
Really, really bad.
Yeah.
So a lot of people that's just starting to invest, that's just getting started, they not going to be able to tell weather this storm. So right now they're making it so if you have tenants, if you have renters, if you have people that you renting to, they still have that bill where they don't have to pay their rent. And a lot of people can't take that hit. So it's getting ugly out here. Courtesy of the Democrats.
Yeah. Alright, boy, look nice. Let me see that.
But yeah, man, I just wanted to say that a little bit, man. Just something on the side note. Just something out.
How much is that?
Out of everything.
I bought it yesterday.
Oh yeah, you can make point payments.
I bought it yesterday. I just paid it.
Ballin'. But look, man, I mean,
what do you mean, nigga? I got money put up.
And you hear me out here struggling?
What you mean? You don't ask me for nothing. You don't ask me. All you have to do is ask sometimes, bro. I'm that simple, bro. You don't ask me for anything ever. You dang, you didn't ask me a thing. Hell, shit. I'm like, what the nigga? You ain't ask me nothing. Don't ask me shit.
You know what? Since you said something about asking, ladies, I want y'all to stop asking us something. Stop asking us how our niggas look. Because you can't answer that.
No, that's a true question. No, you, I understand.
You can't answer that. If a female asks you, do your friends look good? What's your response, man?
Yeah, I don't fucking know.
What's your response? If a female like, goes, hey, I got friends, do your friends look good?
I go down the list.
Nah, that nigga cutest
that nigga stupid, man.
I don't know. I don't know. I'd be like, I don't know. This is my answer.
See, this him. If you like it, you don't. I'm not here for you. I'm trying to press this.
Whoever get the most chatter in my ear, those the ones I teared up.
So what you mean? How you say?
From every chick that I hear, I'll be like, oh yeah, Kevin get a lot of attention, so he got to be high on the list.
Listen, I do it like
Chris.
I do it like
Chris. Chris did a lot. Then they talk about you with the smile. Then they talk about Kale. I just go down the list, bro.
Man, I do it like this.
Okay, that's a good
one. What type of nigga you looking for? I don't know. I like my nigga. I don't really want a nigga that talk too much. All right, let me call Milton. What type of nigga you looking for? I'm just trying to have some. Let me call Nick. I'm just trying to have some fun. Let me call Nick real quick. That's time to look at it, bro. Whatever you in for tonight, I know what you want. I know what you want.
Good boy. I know what you want. Michelle talking like you can't say. Oh, yeah, my nigga straight or like what? He looking, you can't say none of that. Yeah.
What is y'all talking? What are y'all talking about?
Hey, what's my nigga say, fine as fuck?
What? You be like, hey, nah, my nigga get the hoes.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
okay.
I usually just say, okay,
like, that's the first thing I say. Like, okay. Oh yeah, nah, my nigga get hoes.
I never like calling my niggas over that I know are shy. That bothers me because it'd be like, bro, this bitch, I can see what she on, and she ain't trying to, she not trying to court you. She wants you to just damn near tap the mission real quick. So I don't want to call nobody that's gonna be like, yeah, hey, how y'all doing? And this the whole night waiting for you to lead the way, like.
Nah,
like,
I mean,
you do it, bro. Talk to her, my nigga.
The weirdest thing with me, like, I'm antisocial like a motherfucker. I'm not finna sit up here and lie. But at the end of the day, like, if we go somewhere, I'm extremely cordial.
Yeah,
like if you put me in a room with people, I'ma definitely converse. Like, yeah. I'm not the nigga that's gonna be like sitting back
in the
not
dark.
Saying nothing in my dark. Phone, like,
oh yeah, like, you know what that nigga
there. Yeah, like, I'm not that antisocial, but I'm antisocial to a point where I don't talk, like, I don't go out my way to converse with people.
Yeah, because I brought you and Kells over there, so yeah, you was cool.
I get to the point where I get on my phone, but that's only if I feel like shit just ain't going nowhere. Like, if I be like, oh, this ain't my type of bitch, or she tripping, I'll be like, I'll entertain you if you talking to me, but deep down, I'll be like, nah, bitch, you on some whole other shit. Like, you tripping. I can't fuck with no bitch like you. You about to be a problem. Like, this, nah, let me shut up. All right. Yeah, we're going to go to the next subject.
Yeah, but hey, to end the subject, man, my nigga's cute, man.
That nigga's fucked up.
That makes me sound bad too.
Hey, and another thing, I was talking to my nigga Milton about this. Like, hey man, y'all women, I'm sorry. Kevin is on here. I'm about to apologize to y'all because I be dogging y'all. But deep down, man, y'all are backbone, man. We need y'all. Like, I've been listening to a lot of podcasts on YouTube, and it's a lot of dudes that kind of, they make good points, but in all actuality, they make it seem as if women serve no purpose in our lives. But I know, bro.
What you talking about right
bro,
now?
Bro, listen, bro. We just watched.
I had to look at it.
When we watched the podcast.
Go ahead, bro. Go ahead, cook, bro. Let him cook a little bit, bro, so you can eat him up.
No lie. I watched the podcast the other day where Buddy was like, what do you do? What do you bring to the table, right? The question I asked on Facebook. So her points were valid to me. I was like, oh, I ain't heard a woman say this. He was like, you saying everything that I can buy. I'm just like, nah, you can't buy love. You can't buy. She basically saying, nigga, I'm about to love you on a whole different level. You can't buy that. Like, bro was like, you gonna cook? I can buy a maid. You gonna clean? I can buy a maid. You want pussy? I can buy pussy. You want this? I can. It's like,
All right, so at this point, my nigga, what kind of woman are you looking for? Because, bro, it seems like you don't want a bitch at all. Like, you don't want nothing but you and yourself, bro. If you can't expect to find a woman of your dreams, my nigga, if you're literally not looking for nobody. Like, that's what it came off to as me. Like, bro, wasn't he, everything she said, he rebutted with, I can buy that. So it just seemed to me like, damn, nigga, what do you want? Like, I'm confused. As a man, I'm confused. Like, what the fuck is he looking for, bro? Because that shit seemed valid to me. Like, she's saying some shit that's, yeah, it.
I mean, a lot of women do a lot of value things and a lot of things that we don't, can, like, we don't understand the value of it.
True.
Right? Like, a lot of women can help you with, and let's keep it real, they're going to help you with your hygiene. They're going to help you with
support.
Like, they're going to help you with as far as, like, your eating habits. Most, a good woman.
Yeah.
Like, she'll help you with eating habits. She'll probably try and take red meat out your diet.
Yep.
She'll try and get you to start drinking almond milk instead of regular milk. Like,
everything I'm going just, through now.
That's what I'm saying. So, a lot of things that you don't really, you think ain't seeing, you ain't really thinking, it. But it's so minute and small, like, you just like, well, whatever, you know what I mean? But it's value.
Your thing. Life better.
Yeah, it's a lot of small, impactful things that we don't really pay attention to. We just kind of just be
grunting. I do feel what dude was saying on the podcast when he was saying you can buy all that stuff, because that is true.
Yeah, it's true.
But what you saying is basically what women were made for, and that's support.
Yeah.
It's support. That's it. Like, truth be told, we can survive without a woman by herself. But getting a woman, she was support you in anything you doing.
But that falls under. And it also makes your life easy.
That's what I was about to say. It also falls under.
So that's why I was like, that's why I'm like, bro, what is he asking for? Because now you arguing, yo, to me, you arguing what you asked for. She gave you what you literally are asking, and you saying that's still not enough.
Yeah, she didn't get, I mean, she must have not been given the right
answers. Listen, bro.
Because if she would have just said support,
I'll let you hear that after the show.
Yeah, you can't buy support.
I'll let you hear that after the show, but, bro, I'm telling you, it was to on the tee, bro. She wasn't just saying just support. She was literally telling you how I'm going to do it, what is going to be done. Like, no gimmicks or jokes behind it. It was facts. Like, I'm like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, all right, that's damn near what, right. And he still was like, I can buy all that. I'm like, yeah, you can, but my nigga, why waste your money?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? At that point, you just bad with your finances then, my nigga. You either get a maid, then just treat the bitch you with right.
Yeah.
Like, at this point, my nigga, what are you doing? You just bad with finances then. And that's another way when she comes in there. Let's kill all that shit. You eating out all the time. Let me cook. You doing this. Let me do that. Like, bro, what the fuck? Yeah, I'm just like, what is this nigga want?
How long was it, that podcast? Or
It's called Eight at the Table. It's on YouTube. So it was the episode was long, but that little segment was probably like maybe 3 minutes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
it wasn't long. Yeah, but man, goddamn, people, a lot of podcasts are going down that road also, that a lot of men podcast, like a big name podcast, that I think that Kevin Samuels has changed so many directions of people podcast, because now a lot of dudes are just bashing women. They are just bashing them, bro. And it's like,
bro, I think they need it, bro.
No, it's needed, but it ain't needed in the way that it is. Because it's like, we bring you on here, we asked you to come to our show just to degrade you, Loki.
Oh yeah, that's
what it comes off like.
Yeah,
because Fresh and Fit, they do that. They get a whole bunch of women, like it'll be like 8 of them. And they'll just let them talk, ask each one of them their opinion, and then let me tell y'all, each one of y'all, how y'all wrong right now. Like, it's like, why are y'all bringing them then? Y'all can really just make these statements without them being there.
But they got to hear a woman's point of view.
No, they do.
So they need to be on there they can get an example made out of them.
That's disgusting.
Cotton candy? Mm-hmm. No, sir.
I don't know, man. Podcasts, it seem like they all doing the same shit. Every one of them.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's a lot of that. It's a lot of that going on. That's like that.
Go ahead. I mean, that's what I was about to say. That's why I just got so bad with modern women today. Like, it's bad that it even got to get to this point where men got to get to bashing women or something, to be like, feel like we got to tell y'all how to be women again. It's not all of them, you know, it's a majority, but it is bad out here, bro. A lot of them are, like, we already talked about this, too aggressive, too masculine. We already talked about that. They don't really know what they bring to the table. It's only a select few that do. I mean, we've been through all this already, and
that's true.
I just feel like podcasts and stuff, like you saying, doing it because it's a reaction to their action. If they wasn't acting like that, I don't think it'd ever come up. But
I mean, I'm gonna put the accountability on the men. Like I said, we had this conversation a few weeks ago when Kevin went off. Like all the accountability is on us. It's us that let certain things go off. It's us that's letting certain things happen, and now it's in their head that they can get away with certain things. So that's just my.
You know what? Nah,
that's just where it's at.
I'm gonna take that accountability off of us because I'm gonna put it more on, really just white people, the government, and I'm gonna say that because women start using that against us. So for us even be a man, and if you get out of pocket, they can call the police and they ready to lock a black man up and shut us down. So it's like you really can't do too much.
I think Milton's speaking as far as like the way they the way that they're respecting us, as far as like men have given women this complex of you can be lazy with me and not want because I got it like that, and you get niggas who just spoil these women and don't make them be women at all, literally are picking up another child, and then once they're done using what they got out of them, they go to the next nigga and they expect it from everybody. Because look at that chick Blue Jasmine. I don't know if you've seen the video or not, but she had a whole rant about how she was with a guy. He was doing real good for herself. He bought her a Mercedes, got her a new crib, like a loft, badass place, and they broke up. And she was still expecting him to pay for everything. Mm-hmm. And one of the other chicks that was on the show, and this is that ate at the table too, one of the other chicks that was on the show was like, bitch, he was fucking you. You know what I mean? Like, why do you think that you still need to get all that from him? Like, you, he doesn't owe you that. But she was saying like, and if he doesn't do it, what she's gonna do is, she'll start tearing everything. No, she's gonna start tearing everything up. She'll tear his house up, tear his car up. Like,
and that's
crazy shit.
And speaking of that to get to that real point, a lot of things is a lot of men is bringing it to where now there is nothing that a woman has to bring to the table.
Yeah,
but her.
And like that's the
her value is no longer
needed.
Taking care of this or doing that or making sure this is done so I can get to this. Now it's more of
just be
you
cute.
Look good.
Just be cute.
And I value your presence. No, that's it.
And that's a problem.
Okay, that's a problem. But that is where a woman's value is at, is they look.
Starting off, because age is gonna hit you regardless. You can be the baddest thing ever. If I marry you young and bad, and then we get old and you start, that ain't gonna probably. Hopefully, it doesn't change my love for you.
Okay, yeah, I agree with that. Because that's when the support come in. But even going back to what you said, when she felt like she could tear everything up, how does that fall on a man being accountable for how she's thinking?
If he was, because you done gave this bitch this mindset that she's comfortable enough to even think like that around you. Bitch, you got me fucked up off the muscle.
Okay.
I'll buy you all this, but bitch, you doing something for it, and that's what it's gonna be. Now, if shit don't go the right way, I'm gonna tell you off the muscle, I'm gonna need all that back. Like, don't expect the give and take
is out of balance.
So, what it sounds like is he was just providing for his woman, which that's what men do, we provide. Yeah. We give you stuff.
But now, but you listen to what you said, his woman. You not my woman no more.
And that's what I'm saying. When she leave and she feel like she gonna tear everything up, I don't understand how her mind frames fall on him. How does it fall on a man that she thought wrong?
Because the reason being I say this is because he has led her to think that that's you. He has gave you this portrayal of himself to be like, yo, you can do that to me. If a bitch know how you get down, she's gonna be like, nah, I know better.
That's true, but
you gotta give that bitch that type of, I'm sorry, I keep saying bitch, I said I'm gonna stop saying it. You gotta give this woman that type of know about you off the muscle, like you know better. You know, you can be mad as you want about it, shit might not go your way, but you know better.
That's tough, bro. I'm not even gonna lie, because it's like, what can you do? Like, you can't put your hands on her.
But it's
you
still can feel like
as much as you want. And a woman,
she gonna respect
and
you. She
woman,
respect your money.
And no matter what woman you get, they all test you. Like, they see how far they can get.
And then you let that go. I'm pretty sure, because she said they was together for like 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So she should know. You got 4 years to let her know who you are. You know what I mean? Like, that don't make sense to me. You should never have in your mind that if I stop doing this shit for you, for one, like the other girl said, for one, you been with that nigga for 4 years. How you ain't have no escape plan off the muscle?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you obviously weren't thinking. That's why I'm saying he fucked up, because now he done babied you so much that you really have a mindset that
oh, this nigga ain't going nowhere. Even if he leave me, I still got him. You get what I'm saying? Like,
but I feel like when you're in a relationship, you ain't thinking about breaking up. You should be thinking that we're gonna be together for a while.
We might not, but women do. Most women always have an, if this nigga making that much money and I'm living this certain lifestyle because he making that much money, yeah, I love him and yeah, he love me. But if he decides to leave and just leaves me, because I'm not thinking like that, but he could be, what am I gonna do? I have to think about this. Let me put money up. Because if I'm putting this money up and we never broke up, this still our money.
And you said women should think like
they
that?
They should. I would think that they should.
They don't.
Some do, though. Some no, are that smart.
It depends. Women are emotional, bro. No, once that's... they get attached, they attach.
Yeah, but I won't.
Still gotta
unless
think about
you mentally
well-being.
Have them check. I feel like the way they should think like that after they done got hurt, cheated on, and then they mentally check out of the relationship. Now they should start thinking like that. But if everything good and he babying her like you saying, she ain't thinking about leaving. She not gonna think of an escape
that's
plan not, because she attacked.
I still feel like man,
I'm not you're not giving the common the more. I mean, I don't know. You speaking more of the silly side of women.
Yeah, like there's the dumb cute bitch.
Yeah,
that's what it sounds like.
I'm gonna keep it real. Like the women that I've been coming across and the women that I frequent conversations with. They don't think like that. These women, they get it on their own. Most of them.
Yeah.
Like even chick last week. She got her own crib. She got her own all that. All
and I checked your show out if you're watching the podcast. I checked it out. My buddy Marcus in that show, man. I ain't even know that. Marcus Elliott.
Shout out Marcus.
Shout out Marcus.
Yeah, so but I mean a lot of women that I frequent, the ones that I have conversations with, they think like they have the mentality, to be honest, it's kind of fucked up because their mentality is I don't need a nigga at all.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's
like a lot of their thing is the way they move is I'm gonna do it all. I got my own car. I got my own house. My credit good. Blah blah blah. Nigga, you gonna come in this system and help me get better or
see? And that's wrong. Like, I'm just saying, I hear what you're saying, and like, I wish you know old girl from last week was here because I would want to ask her. Even you with your dude now, are you already thinking of a backup plan when y'all break up? Because I just don't feel like women
just
think
feel like
that.
Like he's gonna continue to operate how it's been operating.
Yeah, I mean that's what it should be.
But the difference with that is it's not operating with her on her behalf of he's taking care of everything. I'm saying from a woman who's getting it from the man just taking it. She's not doing nothing. Like that's what I'm speaking of that type of woman. Okay. That ain't doing
that type of woman.
That's what she is though. The girl that I was talking about, that's what she was basically saying. I don't do nothing.
And that's what I'm saying. She's not thinking of an exit plan. She wants to keep getting taken care of.
But I'm saying if you are that type of woman, you should be thinking of that because this whole luxury ass lifestyle you live in is about to get destroyed if he walks out your life.
That's tough to say because everybody lives a certain way. And you know who you're dealing with. So he knew who he was dealing with when he got it. So I can't really put the onus on her of an escape plan or none of that. Like, I mean, some people literally, if they show you who they are right out the gate, you can't be mad. You know what I mean? Because if this is who I was when you met me, don't be mad in the long run because this is who I showed you who I was. I'm not doing shit.
This will blow me up. You got 4 years, bitch. You got 4 years. I am so sorry. I'm trying my hardest. Motherfuckers be making me mad. You got 4 years, my nigga. You need to mold that woman. You have not molded her at all 4 years. Bro, that's so much time.
How old is she, though?
To mold somebody. I think she said she was like 27.
That molding period almost over with.
Yeah, she's who she is now. You're who you are. After 25, you who you are. You who you are, man. You what you is. Like, you ain't changing. Because you can hear, even after all that, she still was, like, it's right. Man, you who you are, girl.
What I'm saying. Like, I mean, it's I always put, I'm a little bit different with accountability now. Like, I mean, I think a lot of people put themselves in situations and a lot of things that's avoidable. I mean, it's us. One thing that we have is choice. I mean, we choose to do certain things. We choose to deal with certain people. We know what come with it. So, I mean, whatever the repercussion and consequences are behind that, I mean, you got to sit with it.
True.
I mean, that's just what it is. I mean, homeboy, I'm pretty sure he was living that lifestyle where he was well off.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Like,
she said
he's so comfortable, I mean, everything functions with a woman. I mean, he just need her body there. You know what I mean? That's mentally, he probably thought like, I could do this for a lifetime. And then after a while where he was like, damn, I might need her to actually do certain things, or I might need this done, or I might need that. I mean, life is always a marathon. We can't always look at the sprints.
True.
That's my take on it.
True. I agree 1,000,000%. Dude, that's his fault. Niggas, stop babying
bitches. That's his fault.
Stop babying bitches.
Yeah, I mean, and that's what we've been talking
about. Babying them. That's tough. Like, what you mean, stop babying? Like, don't take care of your girl.
No, take care of your girl, but stop. Don't baby them. Don't give them the mindset of literally you don't have to do anything. You gotta think she doesn't have children.
Okay, don't bring value.
That's putting
when he's saying baby, when he's saying baby, and he's saying like, I mean, to the point to where you're not bringing no value to the situation.
Nothing at all. You just here.
I mean, nothing is better for me having you around.
With you here, with you here, without you here. Yeah. Like it's just
that's literally
consistent
baby.
Consistent pussy. Your job is to fuck me.
Convenience.
Yeah.
Then she doing something then, right?
Mm-hmm. Nah.
Cause then I can pay for it, like you said.
Nah, I can pay for it.
Nah,
but she's saving you bread.
I guess. Not really. If you paying for a Mercedes and a goddamn Lawson. <Yeah. laughs>
I'm gonna ask a really, 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 really silly, interesting question. It ain't silly at all. Actually, it's probably real. Do it feel better when you love the girl versus a girl that just know how to fuck really, really good?
Yeah, it feel better when you love her. It do to me.
It do.
It feel much better.
It do. Cause
but
I.
But what if a girl know how to, like, she really know how to fuck really, really
that's
good?
That's cool, cause it's still that, after I get my nut, I don't give a fuck.
That's what I'm about to say. It's like, bro, when she giving it to you and she good at what she do, that physical part feels great.
Yeah.
But when it's over, you be like, eh. But now when you love a chick and you making love, and I mean, you got the physical with the feelings in it, you just be like, oh, I love this girl. Like,
you can go to sleep too with her after.
Only reason why I'm gonna say this, because I mean, I'd have had a girl that listen, I hate saying this, but look, I had a situation where she knew what she was doing.
Now put it on.
Like, it's like one of them where you think about it.
Yeah.
Like when she leave, like she didn't stay.
Yeah.
Like, it was no love in it. It was no nothing. But the action.
Yeah, I believe you.
What a great movie.
Yeah, I believe you.
Bro. Oh my
gosh, that movie. Woo, it had every element that you needed in the movie.
I've had those times.
And the climax.
Crazy. Everything crazy. I've had
and what she did with the climax.
Oh my god, bro.
All right,
that's enough,
man. All right, cool. But look, though. On some real shit. So what I'm saying is, a woman that know how to fuck you really, really good and just leave, it's something in that.
Yeah, but that's
I get what y'all saying with the love.
Yeah.
But when she can leave, and I'm talking about she won't even call your phone, she won't text.
That's dangerous.
I don't like that.
Woo. I don't either. That's why I'd rather do it with the bitch I love.
I don't like that shit.
The mystique in it.
Nah, she probably gonna fuck somebody.
And then she'll hit you, like, when you hit her phone, she act like she really like, what's going on? Hey, how you doing? Like, just
like, what you want?
Yeah. Not what you want. Like, she real receptive to you. Like, we had a great time, but it's just like, that was the action.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. It's tough, man.
Ain't the new chick, is it?
Huh? Nah, hey, listen, man. We're not speaking on that. I still ain't had sex this year, man. It's been 8 months since.
I'm about to be like, dang.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I just wanted to have that. I mean, I don't know. I just feel that's a.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I do like the little fucking get out sex. That shit's great, but I don't know that sex I get to fuck and then after that I can.
Yeah. So both of them got their own point. Yeah, both of them are good.
Mean sex is mean sex.
Mean sex is mean sex.
That shit mean. I can't knock you for it, bitch.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah,
but
you're a beast.
Man, she did this thing with my big toe. Never mind, don't worry about it.
Yeah,
hey man, we had a great episode, man. I appreciate y'all, man. We've been doing everything that we need to do. We're gonna continue to give y'all great content
every Monday.
Every fucking Monday.
Gotta be here.
If you're not, you're in the wrong place.
You don't mess with us. So don't mess with us at all.
For real.
Hey, go through the middle and get to the other side. Ride with us, 38th Street. We riding down there for the state fair. Fuck y'all. We out.
We out.
Peace.
That was a good episode.